Hello, this is the Lord's Legion, and welcome to the Antecedent Commentary, the show in which I look at one of my older videos and tear my younger self a new asshole. Now yes, it's no secret that I keep on abandoning this series, and truth be told, there's a bunch of personal shit I have going on right now, so that's kind of your explanation as to why I haven't really done much of these lately. But to kind of make it up for you guys, I'm going to make a new one right here now, which is admittedly going to be a smaller episode, but I do have enough material to go by with the video that we're going to be focusing on. And the video in question is of course the top 10 best villains of all time, which was made over 6 years ago, so at the time I was 12 years old. Now bear this in mind, this video is all in complete text and that there is no voiceover whatsoever, but like I said, I do feel like that there's plenty of material to go by with this video, and also to make it up for you guys, seeing as how many of you really love the Best Villains Ever series, and how the series keeps on doing well episode after episode with a bunch of likes and views, I'm going to be doing some subtle hints and teasers on all the potential villains that I'll be doing the Best Villains episode out of, as well as roughly when they're going to be made. So without further ado, let's begin.
Yo, what's up? It's Jesse. I'm not in right now. Leave it at the beat. Later.
Hey baby, it's Jasmine. I can't see tonight. Something came up and I gotta go away for the weekend. But I'll call you when I get back. I miss you already. Be a good boy.
I'm sorry, I know that this is a bit petty, but what the fuck is that background music at the beginning of the video? Well, if you can even call it music anyway. And how that dodginess didn't get censored by YouTube is beyond me. Yeah, we get it, it's Mr. Freeze. I mean, why even keep this out for so long? I mean, I can't really argue with that one. Mr. Freeze is a heartless villain? This couldn't be any further from the truth. Mr. Freeze is purely motivated by his love with his wife. I still don't understand as to why it takes 10 seconds to reveal the character that you're going to be putting as part of your list. There's really no substance, nor even any suspense. Nobody calls him the King of Evil for nothing. Fucking kill me now, I swear, just end me. Okay, so the reason why you like Ganondorf is purely because of how powerful he is? Really? Not even because of his backstory or motivations or his appearance, no, it's just purely because of how powerful he is. Weak. That is just weak. Is this from The Fresh Prince of Bel-End or something? Because you know, this song choice really does scream evil. He's an evil robot. No shit, Sherlock. You just said he was an evil robot twice. I mean, why even repeat yourself? I mean, with text, it's easier to fix that mistake. Is it me, or is this surprisingly catchy? And honestly, I want to kill myself just by admitting this. Again, I know that this is a little petty, but wouldn't it hurt if we just put Jason Voorhees instead of just Jason? Granted, you just revealed a picture of Jason Voorhees, so I do know which Jason you're talking about, but sometimes maybe not everyone knows who the fuck Jason Voorhees is. Give him credit where credit is due for just a little second. I'm actually proud that my 12-year-old self actually knew how to spell indestructible. $5 motel. Wait, so if we go by your logic, if there's any villain that carries a machete, does that automatically mean that they would be up there as one of the best villains of all time? Because again, that is a weak reason. Is anyone in favor of me fast forwarding these parts? I think it's best I should do from this point on. Just wait till at least number 5 onwards. But yeah, Darth Vader at number 6? That is quite bold. To anyone who's inspired in becoming a big villain, according to my younger self, so long as you wear black clothes, then you'll be up there as one of the greats. I mean, it sure works with Sonic villains. Okay, let's fast forward this. Ah, much better. Are you really sure that everyone knows who Bowser is? What about newborn babies? Do you think that they know who Bowser is? Cause I highly doubt they do. Really? One of your reasons for Bowser being on this list is his Giga form? Even though that is non-canon? I seriously give up. Okay, although you didn't elaborate as to why Kefka is better than Sephiroth, I 100% back you on this. Kefka is a million times better than Sephiroth. Sephiroth is an overrated fuck. I mean, at the very least you touched upon Kefka's personality. I guess that's kind of a step up. You can clearly tell that this is a half-assed video when all you could put for the Joker is ha 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 ha. At the very least you called Ganondorf the King of Evil. Why couldn't you have called the Joker the Clown Prince of Crime? At the very least be consistent. Now, after we was done, me and my freak. Are you guys taking notes? You know, green hair, black clothes, being heartless, murderer. You will be a really good villain if you follow these rules. Oh, and don't forget about the machete. Oh my god, really? You put Taboo on this list? Above the likes of Darth Vader, Joker, and even Bowser? I am really lost for words on this. And what's even worse is the fact that my younger self wrote his name wrong. Do me a favor. He's a god? Is he really though? Because, I don't know, is he a god? He doesn't look like any other god that I'm aware of. Okay, again, the inclusion of Taboo just baffles my mind. I seriously can't get over that. Especially how he was this high on the list. Whoa, what's this? A recap? That is actually generous of you. Now, if there's one positive that I can really give this video, at the very least you were generous enough in giving a recap for the list. Because most videos really don't do that anymore. Oh, it's number one! At least you addressed the reason as to why Venom isn't on the list. That being said, why is Carnage even better? It really doesn't hurt to explain yourself for once. Yup, I'm really convinced that Carnage is the best villain of all time. I mean, granted, I will admit that Carnage is my personal favorite villain of all time, but even I can't deny that Carnage is far from the best. Well, that was an unsatisfying way to finish a video. Then again, I should be pleased about this. So what did we learn here? For one thing, you should explain your reasons as to why you like a certain villain or character, as opposed to having half-assed reasons. And what I've personally learned is to not do another commentary with nothing but a text video. Although at least with the video that we've just watched together, there are at least plenty of material to go by. And I'm not even gonna lie to you guys, I've missed doing these videos. But you know, next time, hopefully I'll have a better video to rip into a new asshole, and I hope that this video is good enough for you guys. And for that being said, I'm going to finish this video right here, and as always, thank you guys for watching this video. Please like and subscribe. Take care, and have a good one.